So in this topic, break-even lease rental, the most frequent asked question has been, which needs absolute clarity, is to write short notes on this concept of break-even lease rental. Okay, which we said is basically kind of a situation wherein the person who is taking a lease is indifferent to whether going for a purchase option or for a leasing option on cash flow term, present value terms. So how much? So this calculation, this concept, this theory says how much should, as a lessee, you be paying the maximum as a lease, and how much as a lessor you should be charging the minimum, and then explore the market based on that, that how much can you get more in that sense. So it becomes a kind of a guiding factor for you, that how much should be going about charging. Like in the previous example, we saw that on his required of return, the lessor was okay with 30 odd thousand of rentals, but then he could have gone up to charging 32,000 rental because of the concept that the lessee is indifferent to purchase of loan as compared to taking it on lease. So if he's going in for loan, then on that comparison, the lease rental could have been charged more. And in that case, if he can see that happening, then he can increase his lease rental and earn more on that. Okay, so it's not just his required of return on which he should be looking to get his recovery of asset value. Okay, so very important concept of late has been coming more as a short notes, but I said as a practice question, you normally get calculation of lease wherein you can bring this concept of lease rental the way we did in this example. Okay.